2500 final, Sir Daniel Similar and Mr. Alex Legaria with a serve Similar 0-0.
You're just joining us. This is the under 2500 final. This is between Alex Legaria from Lindenwood and Danny C. Miller. Alex running away with a quick 5-1 lead. This is a battle of two lefties. I spoke with Danny before the match and he said that as long as Alex struggled with his serve, he would have an advantage, but it looks like Alex isn't struggling too hard and doing really well with that forehand.
2-6, Similar.
Danny doing a little better. And as he had predicted, Alex may be struggling a little bit with the serve now as they are varying more.
Come on!
Alex has great control off of the anti-block.
7-4.
He must have practiced with people who use there just be really familiar. Although I'm not too surprised because Alex seems to have great touch, really, really calm player. Pretty amazing. Now if Alex is able to take this match, he'll only be the second person in this tournament who will beat Danny. We'll see. I think Danny wants to keep his losses just to one. And that loss was obviously yesterday's open singles final, where he lost in 7 to Chi Wei, our eventual champion.
Come on! 9-6.
Wow, Danny really catching up. He was down 5-1, and now 9-7, still down for Danny. I know the first game was really important to him, so let's see if he can pull this out. He has the serve. Oh, really good serve and follow-up.
8-9.
The return wasn't bad by Alex, but Danny's waiting on that corner.
8-9.
Oh, that serve was heavy. Really important point right here.
Come on.
Danny hitting that loop off the corner of his racket. Just really wasn't in position.
Come on.
Oh, a smart kind of flip. It was a no-spin ball, and Alex was able to step in and flip it. Alex takes the first game after a comfortable lead and then a kind of a tough follow-up. But if Danny is going to continue his momentum, it might be a really, really tough match. Alex is super athletic, really great kind of movement around the table, and his touch is really solid, so I think we'll see a lot of big rallies coming up.
One game to zero, Ligaria with the serve. 0-0.
Kind of uncharacteristic miss there. Probably going for too much trying to go down the line.
0-1.
It's interesting to watch lefties play lefties. I think lefties don't like playing lefties because it's also weird for them too. Oh, this is a big rally right here.
Come on.
See, both players know when to go for it and when to hit softly. It's really interesting. Oh, nice block. Just right there covering that space.
3-1, Ligaria.
What you saw there was a false serve. Look, I received the warning earlier. And he gets a fault because he didn't toss high enough. Sometimes that can really mess with your head. You saw that he has just lost 2 points in a row. Let's see if it can. Nice save. See if Alex can recover from. Well, beautiful rally. Danny's playing more aggressive. Alex losing 4 points in a row after that fault serve. Really has to bring it in his head to play well.
Come on!
That may be the point that he needs to stay in the game. Tough serves.
Come on!
Oh, good return.
6-5. Boyer, Dixon, and Sam over Neufmann. Please go to table 15.
Come on! 6-6.
Building momentum, so important in table tennis. So Alex just kind of lost his concentration, and now he's back in it, making those forehands, running around, playing the game that he wants to play. Wasn't ready. He wanted to step around, but that return was too wide. Danny going for it again. Alex kind of scattered a little after kind of the faults and the lets. You have to see if he can bring it back the rest of this game, but I'm thinking that it's going to be 1-1, and in the next game, Alex will have to kind of refocus and fight hard.
7-10.
Come on, be ready.
Sometimes with Danny, as he said, it's really important to serve long. Danny's short game is so good.
11-7, similar one game to one.
Here we go, 1-1 in this best of five. Third game is really, really important. What's important here is to see who can kind of come out of the mental rut. Can Alex, who has, you know, came out of the gate really fighting hard and seems to be losing momentum after the serve fault and the two lets. That's 3 points. That could have been his game, right? So the idea is, can he bring it back? Can he play like he did in the beginning of the first game? And if he can, then Danny's really in trouble. Danny's loop sometimes is kind of dead. Not that spinny, so You'll see a lot of players actually blocking the net. This is something that I've seen over and over again this tournament, especially for playing against Danny. No spin. Alex knew that. Just barely went off the table. You just have to really keep using your brain, keep thinking. It's another no spin ball. Perfect loop. Perfect loop. He knows. He's learning. Smart. See, Danny's loop. Sometimes it's nose and sometimes it's spinny, and so it's hard. You have to really adjust. For this one, Alex could just go cross court. Ooh. Nice return. Really saw Danny just wasn't ready for the wide forehand. Oh, so athletic. That was really good. It's so hard to get around the table like that, and he just put just the right amount of spin, so Danny blocked it off the edge. Too easy. That long serve, Danny doesn't like the long serve, but it has to have more quality. 4-all, tight game here. Tough serve. Careful.
4-5. Come on.
Never discount Danny. He can get any ball back. Although when he's off the table, it's not at his best. So,
come on.
Oh, beautiful serve return. Alex's touch is really impeccable. Danny looking a little frustrated, missing a couple of those short game pushes.
Timeout, 7-4.
Danny taking a timeout, knowing that this game is so important. Well, he's not feeling his groove. Alex didn't force huge mistakes. Danny actually missed some control shots and pushes. Players get one timeout a match. This is actually a pretty common time to use it. The third game is so crucial in a best of five. Danny's also trying to slow down Alex. Alex is playing really well this game. It was 4-all, now he's up 7-4. Alex is just hoping to continue to serve long, attack, and be ready. Alex's consistency is really impressive. Now sometimes Danny can only hit a few balls, quality shots. Alex has that consistency, so let's see what's going to happen. Beautiful loop. His ability to step around is really good. I mean, those are wide pushes, and he just loops them perfect locations. Oh, smart serve receive.
4-9.
Nice push. Oh, beautiful forehand. Danny losing his own focus. I guess that timeout didn't work out too well.
10-4.
It's not smart to push right into Alex's forehand. He was so ready, he didn't even struggle to loop that. That's smarter for Danny. Moving him around. Nice no spin. Oh, nice backhand loop by Danny. Something he's been really working on. Here's where Alex has to stay focused. You know, sometimes that last point to get to 11, really, really hard. Danny's never going to let you have it easy. Here's an anti. If Alex doesn't win this next point, he has the serve.
7-10.
I might consider a timeout. Nice serve.
Come on!
Well, let's not bring Danny wide to the forehand. He has to remember to serve long. No more faults, no more lets. Lagarius seems back in the groove. Doing a really good job so far. The Lindenwood team has been pummeled by Danny's expertise. Taking out both the Skolnick brothers, Felipe yesterday. Danny said that he has often been the second place king, finishing second in the open, second in the open doubles. And here we don't know. This could be still could be anyone's match, but Alex has a nice 2-1 lead. Alex has done much better against Danny than some other players because of his first that sort of forehand athleticism and his consistency, but more than anything, his ability to return Danny's serve. So athletic. And when I say athletic, I don't mean necessarily that Alex hits the ball harder than everyone else here. It's more that you can see him cover the table so smoothly and easily. That's really difficult to do.
Come on! Vamos! Come on!
Wow, it's risky, but really good. I think if Alex can push that long, he has a really good chance. Nice long serve. Danny was ready though. I think Alex has to serve a little faster if he wants to serve top spin to that corner. Oh, it's so hard to loop that second one on the anti. Be careful. Alex cannot get anxious. He's playing a little passive. Look, he's blocking. He's playing to win. Or playing not to lose. And what you need to do is you need to stay aggressive, play to win.
2-6, Legaria. 2-7, fold.
Another serve fault. We've seen this mess with Alex's head before, but at least it wasn't 9-all. Really good forehand.
7-3.
Watch the serves. As soon as you lose that focus, you get anxious, you rush. They're almost impossible to return. There's two missed serves in a row. Sometimes it's hard down 10-3, kind of just want to start over. And I think this is what's happening.
3-11-4.
Here we go, into the fifth game. Danny's been a master of four-game match or full-length matches. I think Alex is frustrated on that serve fault. Sometimes young players, I mean, any player, but oftentimes young players can get frustrated, and then you'll see a string of lost points. You have to keep your energy up in order to win, especially if you want to cause an upset like Alex is right now. Nice loops. Got to get closer. That Ante can be really tough to play with. Oh, Danny playing really well. That was a good rally. If you push Danny off the table, you're in control. Though you have to stay focused.
One, two.
This is a pretty exciting match. It's really lopsided game to game, but these players are actually really even and had some great rallies.
I'm up.
Beautiful forehand.
Alex
still has his timeout. This is his last chance to use it. Again, you can't play to block. You can't play not to lose. If Alex wants to win, he has to fight hard and really attack.
Come on! Come on!
Serving long to Danny is really the answer.
No.
Too soft. Danny can really speed up that block, the punch block. This is tough, 3-5. 2-2, 3-5. This is pretty close.
5-3, similar.
Watch that serve return. No, Alex definitely looking to attack. Beautiful blocking.
Vamos!
Nice. Really good serve return. Alex can't just stand there and push. He has to step around. And every time he does that, he can control the point much more. If you let Danny attack and you just block, it's a tough time. Didn't come out of the corner quite fast enough. It's a little, just some foot speed. This is as close as we can get. 6-5, 2-2. Is this Danny's chance to get a championship title?
Go!
It's only 4 points away.
7-5.
Little bit of luck, but net edge.
7-6.
Alex wasn't ready. Was not ready for that block. It's a high pressure situation. Both players have to think hard. This is Alex's chance to use his serve to his best benefit. Attack. Oh, beautiful point.
Seven, eight.
Come on.
Really tight. Important serve.
Yo!
It was actually smart. I think Alex just didn't execute properly. Here you go, Danny. Danny's two serves, 9-7. If Alex can attack them.
Vamos! Vamos!
That's really important. 8-9 in the fifth. Danny has another serve. This is super important. Danny's so much on advantage. A-10, two serves, left. Can Alex bring it back?
A-10, Egaria.
He has two serves. Probably something really long and has to be really prepared.
Yo!
11, 8, chicken, 2, 2 meters.
And that was smart. He was supposed to serve long. He was right there. He just didn't execute.